Good morning. This is Brian Prasad in the continuing saga of my Chickering grand piano, 190p. And so I was looking over the plate, and I noticed that what I thought was the gilding was really in really bad shape, and it, as you can see here, this is not indicative of a piano maker. So I pretty reasonably assumed that at some point someone took the plate out and spray painted it in gold or bronze or whatever it was. But they did a very poor job because they didn't clean the surface first and buff it out. And I'm actually glad that they didn't, because I just discovered, by taking a little xylene and a cloth and rubbing off the gold paint that was sprayed on here, that they had sprayed right over top of the name and the patent granting. This was not visible when, just this morning. when I noticed that it was spray paint, I got a lot of different things, but I've worked with dyes for metal and glass, and this stuff, xylene, is what you use to get it out and to mix it. And so I know that it's also a really good paint remover, spray paint remover, but you gotta be very careful. It's very toxic and smell is terrible, so you gotta do it like I am here in a ventilated area. But I just took a little on a cloth and started cleaning up around the nuts when I saw the C reveal itself. And then with a little more buffing, the entire letter, and this is like special lettering, right? I mean, it's been blued in there, I guess, because you won't get it out, and which is fantastic. But you can see the golding and the difference in the color between the golding and the actual gilding of the plate. Why anyone would do that? Like, I mean, honestly, why wouldn't you just keep the thing clean? It just baffles me that someone did that, and they spray painted over it. Now, I've spent the last 3 weeks trying to find the serial number of this piano, and I cannot find it anywhere. So I have a feeling that it's the same as this. They spray painted over it. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with you, because this is amazing. You know, Chickering & Sons, patent granted October 5th, 1886. So I guess that's patent granted for this particular design of the plate. Or I don't know, for something on to do with the action or something, I don't know. But I have a feeling that if I keep cleaning, that I will eventually find the serial number somewhere on here, because it's been spray painted over. Anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you soon.